Now, we teach things that are generally not taught in school, as I already have said, but I want to talk about another little factor. 90% of the visits to medical doctors are directly or indirectly related to stress. 90%. If we can reduce stress, and incidentally, the same process that reduces stress is exactly the same process that will enable you to have a long-term balanced career. My stress level, and I face as many deadlines as anybody you know. It's always a book production, a class I'm teaching, a seminar I'm presenting, and each one of them requires time and concentration. Example, how many of you feel like I've made this talk before? Can I see your hand, please? Several hundred times. I made it yesterday. You know what I did between yesterday and today? I spent over 6 hours getting ready for today. You see, I think it would be arrogant if I thought I could stand up and spit it out just because I did it yesterday or hundreds of times. That's arrogance. That's when Buster Douglas knocks out Mike Tyson. That's when an expansion team in Houston beats an established NFL team in Dallas. I dare not. Look at the people here, several thousand. I'm taking over an hour of time. That's several thousand hours of time. Where would my integrity be if I came here unprepared to make something, a presentation that could make a difference in your life? There is no way. You got to prepare for it, ladies and gentlemen. When stress does hit you, how many of you will admit that after 9/11, maybe you had a little stress? Can I see your hands, please? All right. Let me tell you something, folks. If you take the word stressed and spell it backwards, it's desserts. When you respond to life instead of react to it, react is negative. You get sick, go to the doctor. She gives you a prescription, says, see me tomorrow. You walk in the next day. She said, uh-oh, it's not working. We have to change the prescription. You get a little nervous. But she smiled and said, hey, it's working. And so you have just, she's just responded. And you feel better because now you see some real hope in order to get ahead in life. But I don't care how optimistic you are. And incidentally, for what it's worth, I am an optimist. I'd take my last $2 and buy a money belt with it. I mean, that's the way I'm put together. I'd go after Moby Dick in a rowboat and take the tartar sauce with me. Your optimism is an important fact of life.
Ziglar. Inspiring true performance.